Bambin, Bataba. So one in Gunya.
What is this?
Getting all the bad luck out the way. Jeffrey!
Actually several.
Well, two that are in the running. for favoritism.
Nice to meet you, Scott.
Alex is my nephew, my favorite nephew, and Scott is my favorite brother.
Very good, gentlemen. Hopefully, welcome to Sangha, and hopefully enjoy your hunt.
I'm sure.
Only brother and only man.
Day one, we got a couple of baits hung last night. We're going to hang four more this morning, sight the guns in, and then get around to checking our baits we hung last night.
Just think, that was outside the back of your tent last night,
yeah.
And you didn't even hear him. What we're looking for is a nice back pad.
Mm-hmm.
That section on the back, the bigger and wider they are, the bigger the cat. Mm-hmm. You know, length doesn't matter a huge amount on cat wise, but he's got a nice big track. Do you like closer targets?
Yeah. Alright.
Right, gentlemen. Whenever you're ready.
Alright, I'll tell you.
Well, you hit the target.
Target.
It's dead.
Dead
he
off.
Said it's dead.
That was 300. That was 40.
You're all set. We're good. We're good.
Yeah.
gonna set up the blind right here, and they're planning on baiting the leopard down over here on this tree. So we're just clearing out a path right now so they'll have a good shooting lane.
First full day. Have three baits up. We're gonna put three more up. This is our fourth bait. Looks like this is a good place for a leopard to be.
Welcome to Leopard Hunting Alex. It is true technique behind flinging ships, which is key to leopard hunting.
All right. Leonard is the ship holder, you're the ship thrower.
What a good action, eh? Nice.
Look out.
Good man. Keep on doing.
Keep on doing.
Oh, it's smelling. This should be my tree. This should be my pot here.
Your what?
Your should be your
my $10.
Well, you're gonna pick carp.
All right, I'm picking it.
This
is it. What do we call this one? Save one.
Alex.
Alex. That was big.
I'm horrified, but I'm ready.
Follow Mr. Gray. He will lead you forward to the ship. Mr. Graymore, please can you...
That's my
Yes, that's very nice. You are getting very involved. Beautiful. That was on the hand.
Oh, that was a clean miss.
Nice. Right, there was a little bit of a wild dog experience.
Yeah.
Let's go hang this bait.
That was cool.
Thank you. That was really neat. Next time I'm going to go up there with him. Wild dogs were definitely a new experience here in Africa. They're very curious, and you saw that with Philip going and crawling up close to him. So hopefully we'll see them again and get a chance to do that. Right now we're just hanging up the last bait of the day, and hopefully we get some good luck.
Okay, this is where the bait. Look at this, there's somebody's fed you. $100. Mackenzie can go to college.
It's not a very good college, but it's good.
It's college.
It's not a. None of the ribs have been eaten. I don't think it's a male.
Yeah.
But I mean, geez, that's definitely a leopard.
Yeah, shade. Is this the track?
No, these are little. These are civets here. But we'll pick up a track on the road here. Not what we are looking for. I believe we've got two of those already. Come in half. It's always below that mark. Let's go.
idea we were there.
I was like, I'm not putting the sticks up. You are capable to shoot things right by yourself.
I keep kind of waiting for you to put it up, and I'm like, well, I guess he's not going to.
Nope. Well done. Perfect. That was awesome, buddy. I thought that was your second one.
That might be the second one. That's the first one.
Yeah, first one, yeah. First one was right on the point of the shoulder. much easier to do than chase them for days on end.
Nice fat zebra. We hunted most of the morning for one. Got a good shot in the first one, but he broke his shoulder, but he kept running, so we got him again. Tumble, got some pretty good footage on it. Pretty excited to see that. And now we have some more leopard bait.
Exactly what we need.
Thank you, sir.
You're most welcome. Good shooting.
You know, if you hadn't had my supervisory skills, that never would have happened.
You're absolutely right.
Shoot nothing bigger than that.
Yeah, it's heavy, eh?
Nice spot, so you couldn't really tell with the spots and everything else. But we're just waiting for a flat tire to be fixed. Off-wheel jet, see if we can shoot a giraffe. And then 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, we'll go check those baits. See if Sio came back. Might win some money off this one. I think I'm going to win some money off this one. Putting Jeff into more and more debt.
Lots of open ground, but it's nice draft, so let's give it a go. I think you'll stick around. I think we'll find darker there.
Okay.
What do you want to do?
Go stick around, find dark. Let's go look for dark.
Black Mamba, do you copy?
Oh, again?
Black Mamba, do you copy? Come back, please.
Thank you. It's perfect. Well done. You're hired. You're hired.
go.
Shoot.
Perfect. Well done. I think you shot him in the neck. No, that was awesome. Well done.
We needed. Absolutely perfect. On the shoulder, below that halfway line. Mm-hmm. That's why I dropped straight down. You broke both the shoulders. Lovely ram. Nice old boy as well. Good job! Bait. This is going to be the one that shoots the next big leopard.
Yes.
Nice.
Man, that's perfect shot.
Yeah.
Hey, redemption. Redemption.
Redemption. He shot through this bush here. It's very nice.
It's a nice impala too.
Yeah.
Sheesh. You safe?
Can we?
Got up a little early this morning. We're going to go see if we can't get a buffalo. So we'll be doing a little more hiking today and a little less driving around. So buffalo, giraffe is on the agenda.
We'll just wait here, let them move. No. It's so dark. It's in a bush, it's in a tree. Giraffe towards us. Wait, wait. That's awesome. Yeah! That is a black giraffe!
Oh, shit.
Oh, that was awesome. I thought this giraffe was gonna run over. I was like, well?
Did you get that footage of the run over?
That was a great shot, man. He wasn't in the open, but that first shot was perfect.
Yeah.
And then he stopped and stood facing us. And if you hit them properly, this is what they do. I mean, that was, 10 seconds.
Yeah.
Done. Well done.
Thanks, bro. Appreciate it.
African giraffe.
Good job, dude. Thank you. Nice.
Anyone that will give you a shot on the right hand side.
One went down, right?
I don't know which one you're shooting at.
I'm shooting at the one on the right. He's down, yeah.
Perfect.
We found a big track on the road, so we needed some more bait. So shot an impala, shot one, and got two. So we're going to hang another, we're going to skip lunch today and hang a bait and move a bait, and hopefully we can get this monster. Hopefully there's a monster that belongs to this big track and we can get him on bait. Mama. 54 yards, you're the man, buddy. I'll do it again.
Mama, 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 would let's go and see if we can find some buffalo. Upwards, the wind is going upwards. Definitely can't go that way. They're all very low. Yep. Yep. Reload. And again. First shot was good.
Yeah.
Hunched up nicely. Nice old cow, exactly what you want. That's a great ration hunt.
Yeah.
Ooh. They're still there. Let's go up to the sandbank so we can have a look.
Let me get me another bullet now.
Right, there she is. Look at this stuff. Back there. Right, let's go and finish her off. Just below it, whenever you're ready. Well done.
Nice. That was fun.
Sorry for the bum crawling.
Oh no. Good ration bull.
Cow.
Good ration cow. Lots of fun.
Good yeah. Shooting. Well done. That was. I wasn't too sure if they were going to stick around. Just make sure your rifle's still loaded.
Absolutely. So we came down to the river. We found the buffalo. Had a nice long stalk and we shot this cow for rations. It was an exciting hunt. Everybody participated and we got a very nice old cow that they will feed the National Parks Game Scouts with. So this is all part of the conservation and I just got lucky enough to shoot one for free. Thanks, Scott.
Thank you.
Thanks, Alex.
Thanks.
Thanks, Phil.
I see how. Yep, look, there's his mark. There's his mark.
Yeah.
And he arrived at 7:30. Now, has it moved it far? Sitting tonight.
For CO, the oldest leopard known on the in the Sango area, and he didn't come back, so we needed some impala very quickly this morning for bait. So we drove out this morning and we shot these two been about 10 minutes. So we're going to hang some more bait. We've got a new plan for CO, and we're gonna go check our bait and take a drive, maybe shoot a couple more impala today. But today started off with a bang.
Is that good enough for you?
I think you shot under him, to be honest.
But shoot that one. Nope. No, I think.
Shoot that one again. Yeah.
Ooh, well, good shot. Phew, bring in, grab a knife, please. Sheesh, he moved as you shot that. He jumped.
Man, thank you, man.
If it works, it works.
Two more down.
It is completely gone. We think there's a male and two females feeding here. So we're going to look at the trail camera and find out.
They'll be back here. We'll keep these guys going as a backup plan. But I think we'll shoot CO 2 days' time. Alright, square. So the first one, we'll just go find some impala, have a look-see. Did they give you a fright?
No. I kind of expected that.
You're getting perfect.
Appreciate it.
Well done, man.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Can I get that milk?
Yeah.
Feel good, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Talking for a good long while. The birds gave us away for the first few impala that we saw. But then we found this nice one later on by himself. And a little trick that Philip told me was to pretend it was a dry fire, and that's what I did, and sure enough, a bullet came out, one hit, one kill. So thank you, Philip.
Sniper!
Beautiful. So he left here at 20 past 5 in the morning. Let's see what time he pitched up. Honey badgers.
Ojo! Is that the thing? Is that the cat? Is that him?
Yeah.
What? 7:30.
Look at that head.
100%,
that's a beautiful cat.
This is how it's meant. You've had a beautiful male leopard feed. This is the one we've been after that we've seen us track on the first couple of days. He fed at about 7:15, and he fed all the way through the night till 5:20 in the morning. Got a beautiful blind spot, quite close, 40 yards, but it's not that bad. But we're just setting up this light. It's a remote control light, green or red.
cat doesn't even know you're there, so once he's there, we turn it on, click. He'll, if anything, he might look at the camera, the light itself, but he'll never look at the blind. That's exactly what you want. We'll be sitting by 4:30. Let's hope for the best, because a lovely, lovely cat. This is what we're here for.
Jeff, what a pleasure to have you on safari on your birthday. Thank you for taking the time out. Cheers to CO tonight.
Cheers.
Or another monster tomorrow night.
Cheers.
Thank you.
We've decided to sit on a cold bait, which is a little bit unorthodox, but CO's MO is hitting a bait once and never returning. So this should be the time that he comes and hits this bait. Here's hoping. Good thing is that we have another big male on bait. So we'll see how that pans out. And if CO doesn't cooperate, we'll have round two tomorrow night. Perfect.
Two nights here, so we have second.
Johnny.
You sure?
Yeah, 100%. Leopard in the tree, leopard calling on our right hand side. Don't ask me why that female ran out the tree with this light. That's what they usually do. Yeah, I used to be in. Just banana tree.
My guys, whatever. Lens will come in the middle here. One of my guys here, so I'm gonna eat footy.
Oh crap, that's a hole!
Alright, let me just double check where the blood is going.
There.
I'm not going through it, Jeff. You can. You shot the leopard.
Go on.
You go. I'm not going. Screw it. Guy's by himself. Let's get this way. There he is there! Bwana!
Spot is dead. Spot is dead.
Dead. You see the jet?
I have to admit it was Jeff's idea to play that little prank. I said it wasn't funny.
Thank you, Graymore. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Well done. Well done. Thanks, guys.
Things. Man, that is fantastic.
Thanks for the heads up.
That is fantastic. Welcome.
It's from Paul Aswell.
Okay, all right. And you got something else in here too, huh?
Oh, coffee. Beans. I can tell it's beans. Oh, thank you. That was so nice.
Yeah.
He fixed his crown.
That big old block.
Holy cow. Awesome.
Jesus, that's a big cat.
I had one job.
Right.
Oh, I had one job. One bite.
Thank you.
He's getting it.
What?
Oh,
feeling that. We have changed it. This feels it. Pure goodness. It's drinking nothing today. I'm sorry.
Anti-poaching here at Sango, and this is his, and I'll let him take it from here and tell you about what he does.
Yeah, this is one of our tracker dogs. We've got two Belgian Malinois for tracking, and 2 years old now, and fully trained in this environment to track poachers. And yeah, fantastic dynamic because we can, you know, track at night, track in the day. It helps us to catch up and make up the time distance gap when we're tracking poachers. So it's a program that's fairly new for us, a full year now, and we're really, really finding that they're excellent. Great deterrent value, as well as reaction. We train every day, or 6 days a week, ambush work, boundary patrol, and track and attack.
So what are these dogs, what kind of dogs are they?
Belgian Shepherds, or Belgian Malinois.
Yeah. And you get them from where?
From these came from the UK.
Yeah, okay.
So they're from the police military line,
I guess,
kind of thing. But really nice to work with, really intelligent and good in the bush.
Okay.
We've tracked through fast rhino, elephant, lion, we've had leopard interested in, you know, in them and that kind of thing. We tracked them with a satellite collar, you know,
so
an Alpha 100.
Yeah, yeah.
And so the dog's free, but works within our formation, like a military type formation. And the dog, we've trained him to work within that formation, so day and night. So it's amazing to see them actually work.
You'd
enjoy, you know, we track every day 5.5 days training, and it's amazing to see how they work with the guys now.
So you put a guy down in front of them and
absolutely
track them.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we do like, we vary it, so it'll be an hour old spore, and then 3, and then 6, and the next day spore. So we're constantly varying the spore age.
Yeah.
We simulate
real life.
Hot track, warm track, cold track.
Yeah, cool.
So it's, and it's really nice for our guys too, because it's an exciting track.
Yeah. That's fantastic.
Yeah.
How many poachers have caught?
So these guys, not yet. We had an incident where we prevented them killing a rhino. They made contact and they dropped everything and had the ammunition and all that stuff. We caught some meat poachers with them. But we've really just done all the training and we're now fully operational. But we've already noticed a massive decline in meat poaching because of the deterrent. The word's got out. So that's big. But in terms of our other work, our intelligence work and our field work, we've nailed about 7 groups in the last 15 months and accumulated about 75 years of prison sentences. So it's been a good
Thank you, man. That's great. That's fantastic. Awesome. That's fantastic.
Nice.
And this is what, you know, hunting pays for in the Save Valley. Hunting dollars help pay for your salary and the dogs and everything else. So,
it's fantastic to be part of a project like this.
Oh, yeah, this is a laser place.
You know, you have all this diversity in one place.
Yeah.
I agree.
Well, thank you.
Well, we went out to look for the wild dog den and found some on the road. So, Philip says he thinks they're hunting right now, so we're going to follow them and see if we see anything. Thank you.
bait. Got to watch her in the blind. 20 points. So incredible. She was so comfortable. Laid across the stick. Both legs hanging down. It was beautiful. Beautiful animals. So happy. I know not a lot of people get to see that, but that was amazing.
Track a white rhino.
Yes.
A white rhino that apparently is still sleeping, and they've tied it to a tree for us, so we'll hopefully see a white rhino. And your shirt is very white, I've just noticed, but you know, you might think you're a female white. You might think you're a female white rhino, so just heads up. Should be fine. All right, let's go after you, sir.
This is my 18th safari to Africa. By far, the best safari I've ever been on. Scott and Alex came with me, and first time they saw every one of the big five, plus wild dog, and cheetah. Thank you, Alex. And it's just been an incredible experience in Sanga. I mean, everything's been top-notch. I don't know how you top this one. Yanni and Kathy have been perfect hosts. We've had a kind of so-so pH, but we've made do with him. And thanks to my hunting skill, we shot a big leopard. But no, Philip's been great, and we've just had a lot of laughs and a lot of fun, and Mike, the Nat Geo cameraman, has been great, and so it's been a great experience. It really has. I'm blown away.
There's the elephant.
Elephant standing.
We're like, look at each other.
Thank you, elephant.
You don't have to be so serious. Anyone else got any words?
Jeff, it was awesome having you guys in camp. Yes, it was an awesome hunt and only a pleasure having you guys here.
Thank you, it's been great.
And hopefully we see you guys soon.
It's been absolutely incredible 2 weeks here. Exceeded my wildest expectations with the amount of animals here. Yanni and Kathy again, awesome camp. Philip, feel like I've known him for 10 years, great guy, hilarious. He is truly for professional.
Quit lying.
I'm serious, man. He's all right.
Scott, you can come and hunt with me anytime.
I got a place to stay in Harare anytime.
Anytime.
It's been great. Mike, thank you for great camera work. It's just been a trip of a lifetime. Great time.
Plebeian?
Yes, I don't even know how to top that, but really, I didn't quite know what to expect when coming to Africa, and this is just, you know, blown any expectations that I could have ever had. I've had a great time these past 2 weeks. Thank you, Uncle Jeff, for all that, you know, all that you've done to, you know, make this happen.
Absolutely.
For sure, Philip, I've had a great time with you.
Yes, we have.
I better not get into too many things there, but Yanni and you and Kathy have done a phenomenal job. I mean, this tented camp has been, you know, just over the top and wonderful. Philip, thank you for giving me some pointers on how to shoot that impala.
Man, I think you actually missed it. It just died of fright.
That might have been it, too. I don't know.
But, you know, it's also special for me to have my two of my favorite people in the world here with me. Two and a half. And, you know, the first time safari to Africa is always special, but to, you know, experience what they've experienced and to see it through their eyes is really, really been great. And love you guys and glad you could come. And I don't know what next year is going to provide for us, but it won't top this.
thank you again.
No, it won't.
Thanks so much.
No, you guys have
made it possible for us. Yeah.
And Philip, you know, I want to say something about my pH.
Please don't.
You know, we've hunted together 3 times now. We were unsuccessful on an elephant in Gunnera Zoo. We barely missed on a leopard in, where was it?
Arda,
yeah, which is in the Save. But we shot just an incredible cat, and I'm just over the top about this leopard. It was just a perfect, perfect safari. So we'll be coming back to Sango at some point in time in the near future, God willing, and it's just been a great, you know, a great safari. So cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers to Johnny Cat.
Ching ching. To Johnny.
Ching ching.
Ching ching.
Ching ching.
Ching, ching.
And that's a wrap.